If you are watching this video, then you have seen acronyms in written documents. Acronyms are an abbreviation formed from the initial letters of other words and are sometimes pronounced as a word, like ASCII or NASA. They are common document components. Sometimes they are presented nicely, and sometimes they miss the mark totally. These should make your document flow smoother, right? Now, we discover MS Word tools to manage your document's acronyms. Unlike other videos in this series, the Acronym Manager is not tied to the style sheet system. It stands firmly, all by itself. This is a simple-to-use tool to apply in your documents. But of course, there are rules to follow so that your readers will be able to take full benefits from them. First, acronym definitions are made when first used in your document. Second, they are used only when you use the term the first time. You would not define one, then never use it again. You use these to reduce the space in your written documents, not to add meaningless clutter. Instead of writing Uniform Standards of Professional Appraisal Practice, you would type USPAP. While it saves a lot of writing space, it also uses the acronym your intended audiences will know, or want to know. That brings up a caution you should be alerted to. Define all acronyms used, even if you think your audience knows what you mean. I might write about a university campus as just WSU. So, think about that. Will your reader know that you mean Washington State University? Maybe they think Wisconsin State University, or maybe Wyoming State, or Wichita State, or even Wright State University. Of course, you need to define it the first time you use it. Along this thinking, you need to use the acronym each time you convey the phrase. It is not good to define the acronym, then use the full phrase in a later reference in the same document. MS Word has a tidy tool to manage your acronyms. The process requires you to write out the full phrase, name or title, then enter in parentheses the acronym you will use. I use a couple keystroke-saving steps when I do these, and I show them to you now. We might use the phrase Geographical Information Systems and want to define the GIS acronym for that title. Type the phrase and put the parenthetical GIS after it. Select the name and the acronym with the parentheses around it. Be careful not to select any punctuation with it. Use the mouse to open the References ribbon to the Index panel and click on Mark Entry. This does a couple of fast changes to your document. First, the paragraph symbols are turned on so you will see the hidden text the program makes to your document. Hey, don't worry. They do not print, and when turned off, they will not repaginate wacky spaces in your document. Just navigate to the Home ribbon to click on the paragraph icon to turn them off later. You see the main entry as the entire selection you made a moment ago. Use the keyboard to select the GIS by holding the Shift key and arrowing through the text. Use Ctrl X to cut it out. Strike the Tab key and it jumps your cursor to the sub-entry row. Now, Ctrl V to paste your text in that line. The default selects the option of Current Page and you click on Mark. You did it! The display is showing your original text plus wiggly paragraph lines with XE and your text repeated. That part is totally hidden text when you turn off the paragraph returns. Check that by turning them off. See? Nothing's there. Turn it back on. Yep, there it is again. Geographical Information Systems, GIS. This created the hidden and active text of your acronym. You would only do this so that you can make a list of the acronyms used in your document. I place that list after the table of contents, list of figures, and list of tables. In this document, I place the cursor below the list of figures. I type acronyms used and give it a Heading 2 style sheet. Now, take the mouse to the References ribbon, Index panel, and click on Insert Index. An interface applet opens with the Index tab open. Right side, type indented. Columns is 2, and the language is your default language on the computer. I select the Right Align Page Numbers option to make sure the tab leader shows the dotted lines. Looks good, so click OK. It can take a little time depending on how many entries you made and how long the document is. Okay, the speed of your box matters as well. But in short order, they're all done. It looks great. The beauty of this edition is how super fast and simple it is. It puts them all in alphabetical order and shows the page numbers where they were defined. I have completed my documents, put my attention to editing the report, and updated the auto-generated tables like this one. Then I see it. Oh man, I defined the same acronym twice. Oops. Well, that is not as bad as it may seem. I use that verification to jump to the second definition and delete the acronym definition. Without this tool, I would not have seen the double identification of that little acronym. Overall, that is nice and easy. Guess what? If you went through the 9 videos with me to learn more about how to implement the document mechanics in Microsoft Word, you just finished it. I make the observation that your time spent learning these tools to apply to your documents will take you less time on a 15-page report than if you did not do it. Manually creating these mechanics in your reports takes longer than not implementing the tools. If you implement these tools on at least 3 documents in a row, you will have embedded these characteristics into your personal arsenal of productivity tools. I have seen it happen with students, professionals I meet in the workplace, and even more, I watched it happen to me. I did it all manually for years when the software was fresh and no one knew what these pesky style sheets meant. Then I wasted my time to learn something new. Huh, now look at me. 40 years later, I am making YouTube videos to share these skills with you. Okay, it's your turn. Make something great happen with your new knowledge.